to Premium Times. Good journalism costs a lot of money, yet only good journalism can ensure the possibility of a good society, an accountable democracy and a transparent government, all of which is lacking in Nigeria today because its government continues to frustrate the voices of those who speak the truth. One can't help but wonder what the next few years in this country will look like if it remains under this present administration. Look at people out there wasting their precious time, strength and hope, thinking that their votes would actually count. Even if you vote in the right person, what much can they do under a ruler who is gradually manipulating the democratic government into a prison-like government? Which way, Nigeria? 60 seconds with Rolly Adasa. A government that disobeys and disregards its own law. A government where a journalist is charged with treason for criticizing the governor. A government that authorizes the forceful, illegal and indefinite detention of an activist for speaking the truth. A government where law enforcement agents fires live bullets at protesters with placards and speakers. A government that claims to close its borders in order to put to check activities within the country without first finding a solution to possible adverse effects that actions like this might cause on the people and their source of livelihood, while still allowing illegal activities to go in and out of this same so-called closed borders. A government whose major headache right now is to curb the freedom of speech of its people. A government that continuously disgraces itself and its people. A government where all its citizens' number one wish right now is to leave the country as an escape route for the fear of what is coming. A government where the powerful is above the law. Nigeria, now crowned the poverty capital of the world, despite large-scale poverty alleviation programs of successive governments. Corruption, either directly or indirectly, is the bane of problems in Nigeria. Lack of transparency of rules and laws, deplorable bureaucracy, absence of accountability and careless, less concerned attitude of supposed leaders is gradually bringing this country, once regarded as the giant of Africa, to ruins. Crime and terrorism, unemployment, death, depression is the order of the day. The youths are getting it wrong. Two wrongs cannot make a right. If Nigeria truly desires change, then they have to first get to the point where they can come together with one voice and take charge of things. The youths are truly the future of the nation, and the future is now. Enough of looking away, enough of looking for escape routes. Nothing would actually change unless we decide that it should. Kindly share your thoughts, guys. YouTube, Instagram, Facebook and Twitter at Rolly Adasa. Don't forget to like, comment and share with your friends. 60 seconds with Rolly Adasa. See you on the next podcast.